Hello guys, my name is Rui João and today we're going to be editing this image in Lightroom and Photoshop. You can find the link for the raw file in the description below. This was shot with Canon 6D with 85mm at f1.8. So let's get started. I added some yellow in the white balance and bumped the exposure a little. Then I recovered some of the highlights and shadows and added some white and blacks. I then changed the camera calibration on the red, green and blue channels. This added some unwanted saturation. So I removed that saturation and decreased the clarity. On the turn curve adjustment, I like to wash out the blacks and whites and then bring some contrast on the colors channels individually. Next, I went to the Hue Saturation and Luminous Adjustment and essentially made the reds a bit orange and added some saturation to oranges and reduced saturation on yellows and greens. And then added a bit luminance to reds and oranges. Next, I added some sharpening while masking the finer details. Then I added some vignetting and grain to the image. Let's see the before and after. Next, I added some brightness to the eyes and solved some exposure problems, like the bright white wall and the exposure on the end. I then decreased the exposure on some parts of the body and around her face to create some depth on the image. Let's see again the before and after. Now let's bring it to Photoshop. I like to make all the adjustments in new layers, so I create a new layer to fix some blemishes on her face. Next, I apply the technique called frequency separation to smooth the transitions between dark and light areas. For this, we have to merge all visible layers into a new layer and create a copy of that, so we have two identical layers. I then made the top layer invisible and select the bottom layer and went to Filter, Noise, Dust and Scratches. In this window, we have to choose a value that blurs the fine details, like the skin texture, but without blurring the whole image too much. We have to remember the value because we will need it later. Now I selected the top layer and made it visible again and went to Image, Apply Image. On the layer, select the bottom layer, which in this case is called Layer 2, and check Invert. Change the blending mode to Add, and make sure the scale is 2 and the offset 0. Now change the blending mode to Linear Light. Now I group both layers together, so I can reduce the opacity later. With the lasso tool, I selected an area that I wanted to smooth, and went to Filter, Blur, Gaussian Blur, and changed the radius to the same value that we applied on dust and scratches. For smoothing other areas, we only have to select them and then press the shortcut Ctrl or Command F to apply the Gaussian Blur again, without the need of going to the Filter menu all the time. So I selected another area and pressed the shortcut Ctrl or Command F. Then I decreased the opacity to around 80%. Next, I applied some burn and dodges by creating new layers and changing the blending mode to soft light. With the brush selected, with color white at around 10% opacity, I painted some catch light on the eyes. You can see the before and after of that adjustment. Next, I created another new layer with blending mode soft light and painted black on the eyelashes. Then I changed the brush to white and painted on the white part of the eyes to increase the depth of the eyes. Another layer with soft light, this time to add contrast on our body. This time I created another layer with soft light to add a green color to the eyes. Next, I created a curves adjustment to match the color of the gate behind her with the green color of her eyes. Now, to apply the adjustment only to the gate, I inverted the mask with Ctrl or Command I, and then, with the brush set to white, I started painting on the gate. Next, I created another curves adjustment to change the overall colors of the image. I added a bit of red on the highlights, and on the blue channel I added yellow on the highlights and blue on the shadows. I then reduced the opacity of this adjustment to about 20%. Next, I created a new layer. And with the brush set to white, I painted her lower lip. Then I double-clicked on the top of the layer to open up the blending options. On the underlying layer, I pulled the black slider to the right. This way, the white brush is only applied to the bright parts of her lips, which enhanced the highlights. I then changed the blending mode to overlay. I did the same thing on her upper lips. Only this time I reduced the opacity a bit more at the end. Next, I created another new layer with the blending mode set to soft light. This time I wanted to make her eyes a bit brighter. Now let's add some sharpness to the image. Merge all layers into a new layer and go to Filter, Sharpen, Unsharp Mask. In this case, I went to something around 120% and 1 pixel radius. Now let's go to Blending Options by double-clicking on a layer. Here, we can remove the sharpness effect on the shadows to avoid noise and remove some of the highlights as well. Let's see the before and after. I don't know if you will be able to see any difference because it's very subtle. Next, I noticed the image was a bit too red for my taste. So I went and created a curves adjustment and made some tweaks. Now the edit is done, so let's merge all layers together with the shortcut Ctrl-Shift-E or Command-Shift-E on Mac and save the photo. Let's go back to Lightroom. Now let's compare the edit in Lightroom on the left with the photo straight from the camera on the right. Now the edit in Photoshop on the left and the edit on the Lightroom on the right. And lastly, the edit on Photoshop on the left and the photo straight from camera on the right. I hope you liked this video and feel free to hit that subscribe button, like or comment below. See ya!